Welcome to Brildor, the best personalization channel in English. Today we're going to show you a new technique that is currently gaining a lot of popularity in the personalization market, DTF printing. DTF printing stands for direct to film, and as its name suggests, it consists of printing your design on a type of acetate and then transferring it onto a garment. Do you want to know more? Well then stay right there as we tell you everything we know about it. As we just said, DTF prints on a film to create something similar to a transfer. This technique is similar to no-cut transfer paper made with a white toner laser printer. But here, we will use an inkjet printer equipped with special DTF inks and white ink. These are very flexible textile inks, which brings it closer to DTG printing. You probably want to know what are the consumables and the equipment needed to make it work. Requirements. DTF printer. As there aren't any dedicated printers for this technique yet, we need to adapt a 6-color printer to be able to print in CMYK plus white, and another tank of white for the final layer. Our printer's hardware has also been modified. Its front rollers have been removed to avoid print marks, and we've added a waste ink collector. DTF ink. This ink is more fluid than DTG inks, but are just as flexible, resulting in prints that can be stretched without cracking. They are also cheaper. DTF film is the support that carries the ink and allow you to use it. It keeps the ink wet, but prevents migration, while also being heat resistant, similar to Sublimagic and Laser Dark No Cut. DTF powder. It is the adhesive needed to transfer textile ink to a garment. It sticks to wet areas and must be cured at a similar temperature to that of DTG pretreatment. Heat press. You can use any heat press, but we recommend an automatic press that will allow you to cure the powder by choosing the height of the platen. Rip software. Because the printer has been modified, it is necessary to transform the pattern information to the printer so that it can print the color correctly and the white layer on top of it. Printing. DTF is a very versatile technique that you can apply on cotton of any color, as well as on polyester and their blends. The print must be prepared and printed using RIP software that will help you control the size of the print, its quality, the white underbase, and the order of the layers. See how it prints color, then a white layer on top. After printing, try not to touch the ink because it will be wet. Apply DTF powder, which will stick to the ink. Don't forget to shake the transfer gently to remove the remaining powder. Return the remaining powder into the sealed container to protect it from humidity. Curing. After applying DTF powder, you will need to cure it with a heat press. The easiest way is to use an automatic heat press like this one, which will allow you to position the platen a few centimeters away from the film. There are two different methods. For immediate application, you will need to cure the powder for 2 minutes at 165 degrees. The powder is dry, but you can still see its granular surface. For a later application, you will need to cure the powder for 8 to 10 minutes at 190 degrees. This method melts the powder to produce a result similar to a screen print transfer. You can then apply it at any time or send it to your customers. Pressing. It's easy to apply, but you will have to consider the type of fabric on which you're going to print your design. For cotton fabrics, prepress the garment, center the film, and press for 15 seconds at 165 degrees. When the time is up, remove the garment and let it cool. Once it's cooled, remove the film with a slow but steady movement. It's very easy. If the fabric is made of polyester, center the film on the garment and press for 50 seconds at 140 degrees. When the time is up, let it cool and remove the film in a steady motion. Examples. In addition to t-shirts, you can also print other types of garments, such as jeans, cushion covers, and many more. We're now going to show you how we've personalized this tote bag. You can also prepare a sheet that will work as a screen print transfer for later use. Let's see how the process will look like when personalizing a face mask. Rating. When you look at the different prints, you'll notice that the colors are of high quality, and that this technique gives you a soft and elastic finish. After several washing tests, we have found that the prints are very durable, which makes it a highly recommended technique. The cost of the equipment and its reasonable printing costs make it a good technique to use alongside sublimation, and may even lead to it replacing some of the others. We've calculated the cost of an A3 print, including the inks, the film, and the powder used, and its total cost can be less than 2 euros. This calculation varies according to the mass of the design and the quality of the print. DTF can be an approach or introduction to DTG, thanks to its versatility on almost any type of fabric and any color. Its downsides are, like any inkjet printer, the risk of printhead clogging increased by the use of white ink, which has a higher sedimentation than other colors. The most interesting feature is the ability to clean the printheads without the use of a consumable, such as a maintenance tank, because the printer has a waste ink bottle and a software for resetting the ink pad counter. It's pleasant to the touch because it is fine and elastic, but it needs light ink designs with free spaces to make the print breathable. Conclusion. Every argument for and against this technique has now been presented. In a future video, we will show you how to install and use the software. DTF printing is a new technique that intends to settle down permanently. You can go to Brildor to order your DTF printer kit that's available right now. We hope we've been helpful. Don't hesitate to share your doubts in the comments section and don't forget to click on the like button and subscribe to our channel. See you soon!